Steve Dotto, how the heck are you this fine day? Me? I think I could best be described today as being peachy. Thank you for asking. The topic du jour is Zapier. It may be pronounced Zapier, which actually I like better. Zapier sounds better, but I think they pronounce it Zapier. Zapier is automation software, allowing one business app to speak to another app. It's very similar to a product that we looked at earlier called Ifttt, but it's more business-focused. It allows us to take repeating tasks and automate them, even across different applications. It can be an enormous time saver. So stick around and learn today a little bit about Zapier. All right, let's get going and have a look at Zapier. But before we do, a quick shout out and thanks to all of our Patreon supporters. Dotto Tech is brought to you by you, by the people who subscribe to this channel and want to see us continue. And they support us through the crowdfunding site Patreon, which allows us to continue to work hard to produce compelling and better content each and every day. Now, today's content, as I said, Zapier. It's a little bit of a difficult concept to understand, I think, until you start to realize how much integration there can be between different applications. We all know that we take email and we use it to create appointments within our calendar. That's the sort of integration that really adds to productivity. And what Zapier strives to do is to take that sort of integration to create automated processes between all of our different business and social media applications, our customer service applications, to allow certain triggers to happen. And they call them triggers, certain triggers to happen and cause an action in another application. So let's just jump in and take a quick look. Now, if you want to get a bit of a primer, we've looked at an app in the past called Ifttt, which is a little more open sourced version that does pretty much the same thing as Zapier. It's a little more social media focused, where Zapier is definitely business focused. Ifttt is free. I think it's free, completely free. Zapier has a paid model. So let's just dive in and take a look. Actually, before we do, let's do this. As soon as you sign up for Zapier, what they will do is they will send you this document, which is a great primer document. With apps like Zapier, you really need to see what other people are doing to spark imagination within you. So you can say, oh, that's something that might work for me. So this there's 101 uses. I don't expect you to read through all of the uses, but here's kind of the 30,000 foot level types of things that you can do. Automate your inbox, time management, project management, file management, archiving and backing up. Just start to get a feel. Social sharing, social media monitoring, news and notifications, going on to lead generation, customer support, even into accounting and invoicing. So all of these different actions, you can start to create cross-application pollination for anything that happens, for any action that happens. So this is a great tool to go through. And as you go through it, or a great document to go through. And as you work your way through it, they give you examples. And the cool thing about these the different Zapier actions, and they call them Zaps, is once one is created, you can use it. In Ifttt, they call them recipes. And I actually like that word better, because it's a recipe that you can then follow and you put your own ingredients in. So all you do is you basically sign in and give permission to your Gmail account and to your Trello account. And all of a sudden, those two apps can talk to each other through whatever the programming is that's created in the Zap. And I think it's now time for us to take a look. So when you start, they have a free trial for 14 days, and then you can choose a free plan or you can choose a paid plan. I will show you the plans at the end of today's video, but let's just go in and start a new Zap. Now, this is a fresh virgin account. This is a complete virgin account. So I'm going to be doing the same things as you'd have to do when you first open the account. I have no integration between any of my apps or any of my services and Zapier. So you start by choosing a trigger app. A trigger app is where the first action takes place that causes a cascading series of events. And here you get a peek at just how potent this application is. Look at there are applications in here that I don't even know. Well, first of all, Aweber, that is my email tool. So immediately I'm going, oh, I can do stuff with my autoresponder, with my email software. So as you take a look through it, they've got Amazon SES and all of the Amazon's online services. There's lots of apps here that I don't even know what they are. They're small vertical apps. Oh, there's Constant Contact, another autoresponder. As you work your way through, Dropbox, of course, Discuss, The dialogue manager for Emma is another email program. Eventbrite, love Eventbrite. Ah, look at that. Evernote, Evernote Business. Ah, good to see those in there. But if you go through, you will see there are, I don't know, but there has to be hundreds of different apps that can cause triggers to happen. So let's do something simple. Let's just go for some low hanging fruit, and let's see if I can create a Zap that will automatically reply when somebody starts to follow me on Twitter. Does that make sense? Okay. So I've chosen the app to be Twitter. Now I choose a trigger, and here are the triggers that are available to me. I can, if there's a mention trigger from the mention of a search term, something, if when I tweet something new, trigger when a specific user tweets, so I can follow somebody from mention when there's a new tweet, when I get a new follower. There it is. So they actually have that as a predefined selection. So what am I going to do? I want to tweet back to them. I want to say, thanks for following me. Something just simple. And you know, I might be able to actually do this in Twitter. I've never actually looked, but I might be able to do it. But it'll give you an idea of the sorts of things we can do. So now choose an action and create a tweet. Although it will be limited to 10 per hour. Well, I don't have more than 10 people following me in any 1 hour. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to create a tweet. All right. So when this happens, when I get a new follower, create a tweet. Okay. Now, this doesn't show us cross-platform pollination as opposed to, I mean, typically speaking, I might be going into Gmail here and asking it to send me an email that there's a new follower. You can do all of those sorts of things. It just requires integrating the other accounts. Now I have to connect to my Twitter account. So name this Twitter account. So steve@dottotechs.com's Twitter account. Okay. Follow Zapier. Okay. So it's asking if it'll auto-follow. Now it's asking to authorize the app. So once I click on the authorize the app, it sends me back and it creates this Zap. I say continue. Let's test it. Okay, it's testing the account. The account's working. Okay, so it's, okay, I see what's happened here. It's going to both sides of this equation that we created, Twitter to Twitter. So it actually had to test both sides. So if I had put in Gmail or something else in here, it would be testing the Gmail account as well. But it's just confirmed that they're both talking to each other. So the filter, only trigger new follower and trigger one. Okay. Now it's asking what the message is going to be. Then once I've composed the message, and now I test it. So once it's tested, every 5 minutes, this is called new Twitter followers. And I turn the Zap on. It's working. So now we go back to my dashboard and I can turn this new Zap on and off. So did you get a feel for how that works? Before we leave, I'll just start to create a new Zap. And it auto saves, so you don't have to worry about losing it. But you don't have to worry about losing it, and you don't have to worry about constantly saving as you go. But let's say that I was going to do another one. Let's say I was also going to create a email to myself when there's a new Twitter follower. Now, of course, Twitter will do that automatically, so maybe I can come up with something better. Let's say I'm going to add it to a Google Docs spreadsheet. I'm going to add the username to a Google Docs spreadsheet. So I type in Twitter. So I choose that again as my trigger app. But now I'm going to choose as a action app Docs, Google Docs. So I start typing in Google, and here's the things I can put in Google. I can put in Google Docs, Google Drive, Google Tasks, Google Glass, Google Contacts, Google Calendar. Oh, maybe add the Twitter follower to Google Contacts. Why not? Let's just do that. That's something that's unique. And choose create a new contact. So the trigger is when I have a new follower, create a new contact. Oh, that's cool. So I connect my Twitter account, and I continue, and now let's see if it allows. Oh, it's asking me to authorize it again. But it already had my information there, so it authorizes it very quickly. I'm going to now continue. And now it's going to ask me to connect to my Google Contacts account. And here, I can create that. This app would like to manage my contacts. So Zapier is asking permission to manage my contacts. And now it's been connected. And I continue. And so on and so forth. So now I will continue on through and finish creating this content. I'm not going to go through the entire process for you again because you've seen how it works. Now, because I want to get into the pricing because this is, of course, quite important. So they have 1, 2, 3, 4 different plans on Zapier. And the nomenclature here is very important. There's tasks and zaps. So here's how it works. With your free account, you can have 5 zaps. What we just created, the Twitter to Twitter or the Twitter to Google Contacts, those are each zaps. You're allowed 2 basically recipes that you can create in order to and use for free for $0 per month. And you're allowed to have them perform 100 tasks. So every time I get a new follower and it launches that sequence, that is a task which is then completed. So we have a limit of 100 and with 5 different recipes that we can follow or 5 different zaps, and that is the free plan. To upgrade to $15 a month, you're allowed 3,000 tasks, which is an awful lot, I think, and 20 different zaps that you can create. And it runs, and it tells you how quickly they run here. So they run every 15 minutes, and in the premium plans, they run even faster. So there's even more integration, and where you can see up to $50 and even $100 a month for people that are really using this very heavily. And they obviously have customers that are gonna be able to take advantage of this. This creates a automated workflow for things that people used to have to do manually, or they used to have to pay hundreds of dollars to have programmers come in and alter their software to create this sort of linkage. And it does everything. You know, we've looked at business, we've looked at social media. It crosses over all of those different barriers. It can work great in the accounting area when automatically when an invoice is created, it creates a series of chain of events based on that invoice. Just some really great services based on a trigger based on something starting a series of events that follow on. Overall, I think they've done a beautiful job with Zapier. It's got a very clean interface. It feels very businesslike, and it's quite trustworthy as far as you feel like you're connecting to your accounts in a reasonable way. And the clarity as you do each of your connections and create your own zaps seems to be quite good as far as I'm concerned. So I think Zapier definitely worth a look at. The 14-day free trial, and then the free version allows you to test it out and make sure that it fits in your business practices. That's all the time that we have today. I hope that you've enjoyed our little video and found it useful. If you're interested in becoming a part of our little community, there are, I guess, 3 things that you can do. You can subscribe to this, to our channel here on YouTube, and we certainly appreciate you subscribing. We are on a journey to 100,000 subscribers, so every one of you helps. So please subscribe to our channel. The second thing you can do is sign up for our email list. Every week, we send out an email, which is a digest of all of our different activities here on Dotto Tech, and you're welcome to sign up for that newsletter and be informed of everything that's happening. Plus, you get early notice of all of our different special webinars and different special trainings and tutorials that we put on. So please subscribe to Dotto Tech. And finally, if you'd like to, please consider becoming one of our Patreon supporters and helping us fund this venture, allowing us to spend more time and energy creating compelling content, which I hope that you have just enjoyed consuming. And that is it. I am out. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.